The Crafting Nook, The Crafting Nook, The Crafting Nook, The Crafting Nook.
Hello everyone, welcome back to the Crafting Nook. I'm Enoch, this is Felicia. She's going to show you everything you need to know about crafting.
Okay y'all, I'm going to do a nice pan around of my shop, okay? This is the wall that I keep my little notes and things like that, okay? Excuse my voice, it's very raspy, it's early in the morning. Up there are some molds, jars, ink dispensers, little rocks and things like that. On this, it's like just general stuff that I may use or that I'm gonna try, and it's just there. I have a little, what do you call these things? Some glitter chunks. Those are the little fake little pearlescent abalone shells, the fake moss, more glitter. Okay, yeah, these are just some things that I use, the gears, things for like keychains, some extra rocks, more keychain stuff, the gold, the silver. And these are the glass mirror chips, more glass mirror chips. And like I said, that's the fake abalone pearlescent color. I have two jars. So yeah, I didn't have enough room to put them in both. And these are just extra rocks that I bought from like Dollar Tree. Here is some paints that I've mixed when I was doing like trying to do the acrylic colors and stuff like that. They haven't been used, and you see there's a little bit of water in it, you know, just to keep them fresh because I wasn't using them for a while. But I didn't make the red, I didn't make the yellow, I didn't make the green, but the orange, the blue, this purple, this lavender purple, those are ones I made. I didn't make the white, of course, and the black. This one is a color I made. This is just a the Aztec gold. I made this gray. And those, they need shaking up and stuff like that, but I'm very seldomly over here. Like, I did good with making the colors, okay? So they turned out nice. Having you over back here is just extra paints that I have, extra micas that I didn't get a chance to put over in their place. These dyes are from the Rit dyes when I was going to make my own crystals. And I've made a few. Let's see, can I reach them? Oh, I can barely reach it. But, like, I'm trying to show you, like these crystals here. And I just made them just because I wanted to see, could I do it? Take it back a little bit. Yeah. So, just made something. So, put that down. So, panning you over, and I'll have to stand back for this one. Here's more of my paints. So we go all the way from the top. Those bottles there are some more paints that I made. Then you have some of the cheaper paints, and those are like the fast dry paints. Those are from Ateza. All of these are Apple Barrel. I got a nice collection of Apple Barrel, but I did get some Waverly Way right there, there, and there. Some more mica that's not in its place there and at the top. Okay, those bubbles, when I created those bubbles, I'll take you in a little bit. I wanted something that would show me the actual color so that, you know, no matter if I picked a color up, it may not be the same. Okay, for instance, this one, this is a very pretty color and it's Tuscan red. Okay, but looking at the bottle, it's not so much of the Tuscan red. So that's why, you know, I've done those. Here is some sheens and Color Shift and Folk Art. I do have some of those. And that's just what I've done. Moving on around, okay. Of course, my little sewing area. I'll go in a little bit closer. These bobbins are like for general sewing, just your regular general everyday sewing. These bobbins are for embroidery. Those are for embroidery. And all of these threads here, those are all embroidery threads, except for those. Those are general purpose threads there. And more threads, and I try to, you know, keep them out so that when I used to have customers coming over, they could pick out, you know, the thread that they wanted for their particular item. Up there are my hoops for my embroidery machine, the 4x4 and the 10x6. Okay. Up there, I know it's paints, spray paints. I think it's one or two acrylic paints there. And I'm gonna pan you around up here. So those are paints beside the Raid. Those are little teeny bottles of paints. Some of that, those boxes up there, which is not all of them, but when I upload software onto my computer, it's like I keep the boxes and things like that. I do have them somewhere else. That Arteza boxes from when I ordered some, those Arteza micas. And let's see, can I get around here? Those are ribbons when I try to make reefs, but I was unsuccessful. I mean, I did a couple, but it's nothing to brag about. And my transfer tape, and in the middle, the transfer tape is there. I use that doing decals and car decals and glass decals, anything that I have to transfer vinyl. The middle one is like a wash away that I would use for like when I'm sewing an initial on a towel or anything like that. This big piece right here, that goes to my embroidery machine. That's for when you do general sewing. All of this stuff here is just random things. Let's see, can I get a little bit closer? Because see, I have stuff in the floor too. Cabbage patch. This is my flying ant bait. But it's nothing here, just general stuff. Nothing is even in order. When I worked over here quite a bit, I had it in order, but now it's not. It's not. Extra scissors. Extra scissors. Extra of these little square bins. It's little decal stickers. This right here, because I make candles also, but I haven't made any in a while. If y'all find that y'all want to see me make, you know, a candle or whatever, then we shall do that. But this here is just random. I went a little crazy. When I was looking for stickers and stuff like that, And I went to Hobby Lobby and I went crazy, y'all. I went crazy. Oh, I love my anchors. That's what that is, okay? This stuff here, this tells you about the different types of stabilizers that you need for your sewing. These are colors of different threads that I use. Let's see. Can't take you down to the table, but I'm going to back up a little bit and continue to pan around. That's my grandbaby, y'all, when he was born. He wasn't even a day old. My husband is holding him. I'm holding him. And then those two are by himself. Over here, it's nothing here because I have to finish. Okay? That little tree thing is on top of my refrigerator. Yes, it's a mess. It's a mess, okay? But that's not what this video is about. Now, over here, I have just random stuff again, you know, like just random. It's nothing here. Little dryer, the hyper tool for sanding, the little jello cups are up there. Those are the lids. I have no purpose for the lids. Those are some paint brushes and, you know, the drainer from, you know, when I use like Floetrol or something. This here is extra heat, the heat gun attachments, extra little sticks. Back here is like my, that right there is what I would use to make designs into wood, my wood burning tool. Here's just acrylic stones, rocks, drop cloths. Right here, I just have to start from the top. Okay, so this is like extra peg pieces. When I use my peg boards that are pieces like this. Okay, this is extra ink droppers. Moving down to here is something I shouldn't have ordered from Amazon. It's just a lot of glitter. These are more acrylic chips, not acrylic chips, acrylic rocks. Here is like different foils, the copper, the pink, the pens for the molds. When I've done a few ink pens and, you know, I didn't like them, but. Moving back on up. So up there, there's, let me move over. This is some newer molds up here. Some more molds in there. My respirator. I always keep it in a bag, okay? Then I have this like humongous mold of a landscape. That's another checkerboard. Here, there is, let me move over. Oh, I didn't go down. So under the molds, the newer type molds, okay? I have like, this is for like gems that I can use to make gems. Further down, my messy heat guns. I have a newer one. It's in the house though. The one that you, it's cordless. Okay, then my, just general stuff. General stuff. I just dropped scissors there so they can be handy at my workstation. This is a dryer that I made. You know, the ones with the brush on the end. Well, I detached the brush and put me a graduated cup on the end so that when I do the acrylic, I can blow it. And this one is another dryer with a lower wattage, and it is for blowing acrylic paints. Moving on back over here. Now, This is a mess. Let me cover that up. This is a mess, okay? Yeah, it's a mess. This is a little stand, a three-tier stand. And I keep, like, a lot of stuff over here. You know, I just did this video with these rocks. So I've got to put them in a container so that they won't be everywhere. A lot of these are just, like, stuff that I made and didn't put up. I didn't put none of that stuff up yet. Didn't put this up. I used to love this video. Well, I did love this video with these, this nice coaster, the coaster set. Back there is some more foil rocks, the glass rocks, the golden glass rocks. There's a little bit of silver. There's some the pink foil. This one is the silver foil. And I have a lot of pens that I just don't use. My main ones that I use is on my table. I never use this thing. I just need to put it somewhere and give it away to somebody or something who would use it. You see that? The mixed resin. Don't you know all of those holes will be in that resin? That thing is powerful. But, that is my dryer for using UV. I'm not going to really show you this down here because it's totally a mess. I've got everything down there. Trash can. But, okay, so going back up under my respirator, I have, like, different micas. That's my UV. I'm almost out of UV. I got to buy some more. And by the way, if y'all want to donate to the channel, y'all can donate. If it's $1, $2, it helps. It really helps a lot because, like I said, I'm not working, but I make sure that I, you know, bring the videos to y'all. I want y'all to be able to see, be able to experiment, and all of that stuff. But this is my Lorez Angel White. That's just resin. I don't have a spot to put those just yet. These are from Lepore Art. I think I showed y'all these last night from the Chameleon paints. This is from Advanced Metallics. Advanced Metallics has some great glitter. It's like metal, y'all, and it's really nice. Y'all saw me pour a little bit of the gold pen into that. This is my Boysenberry Sparkle. I'm not showing you the right thing. This is my Boysenberry Sparkle. It's very pretty. Like, it's got like this color shift. I think I want to use that on my cup. On this next row, I have my May Spring collection. So I have a collection here. This is two different collections. Maybe even three. So the Green Morphite, Paramorphite, the Bronze Stone, the Violet Crystal, the Turquoise Blue, the Silver Druzy, the White Chalcedony, the Rose Quartz. Those belong to the gem collection, okay? But then you've got the, I've got the May Spring, well, I know what this is. This is the Mermaid. This one is the Charcoal Black. And those two there, they belong to the two-tone collection, which is the first collection, okay? Here, I just have a lot of them from the newest collection, which is the Geode Art Collection. And I just put them in these bottles. My heat gun missed and melted it, but that's that collection. Moving on to here. This is Let's Resin, and it's the pastel colors. They're okay. I'm not going to say they're the best. Maybe I would use them, you know, later on again. I don't know. These are the Lorez products here. And y'all got to excuse my little bottles. Maybe I can, I don't know what I'm going to do to get it cleaned up. maybe I can ask for some more labels and, you know, redo it myself, because I was making a mess with shaking them and all that kind of stuff. These are just some glow-in-the-dark micas. These are Oyawa. I don't know how to pronounce it. Anyway, I thought they were cute. They're pastel colors. And that's just what I have there. And it goes all the way over for those pastel colors. Okay. Then I have some. All of this is Color Passion here. This row is Color Passion paste. And here is Color Obsession paste. All of this row. This is my tester's ink. It's like model ink, paint model ink, but I use it for a lot. This right here is the these are the Ranger inks. They belong with them. Okay. I've used it one time, but I've got to try again because I wasn't successful the first time. I have my speedball for like laying down the foil. This is from Chameleon Inks from Glitter For You. No, glitterandcraftsforyou.com. I think, to me, if I use the powder, I think I'm better at the powder than the inks. This is Sparkling Jade, Interfere Who, Interfere That, Don't Fuchsia Around. These are, I think, from the latest collection of the Let's Resin. We did a video on that. Okay. This is Nick Pro ink dye. This one, I don't think it has a name, but I needed some more inks because I think the inks that I originally started out with, I think they're kind of fading. After you don't use them for a while, I think they fade. I don't know. That is some Let's Resin, the Mixology, one set of them, the Mixology Glitter. There I have from All That Glitters. They are nice, y'all. They're really nice. And I just put them in these little tubes here. I like to have things placed into my own tubes and things like that. It's more convenient for me. Okay. This is Glow Art AZ. They're affiliated with PuDuo Resin. So those glow in the dark, they're awesome. They're really awesome. And y'all know that I just bought those, okay? And some tools and things there. And back here, Black Diamond Pigments, they sent me their collection. So it's all of their colors into that little box. So I may just get a, I don't know what I'm gonna do just yet. I don't know whether I'm just leaving them in their packs because I hate the packs. I may just put them into, I may see, can I find something like this size to put them in? Because it's not a lot that's in there. Okay, so we're moving on. I keep my spatula sticks, tape, masking tape, spreader, a mask. That's from when I did the 3D fish. It's more of those somewhere in the shop. These plugs here, they're just what I need sometimes, like. One of them is for the camcorder, the other one is a mic, and so forth and so on. Now, when I told y'all that some of my inks are fading, okay, this side of the room does not get sun, okay? You see how this is? Let me take you in closer. You see how that is? It wasn't like that. So over time, it changed. And although there's no sun over here, but it changed. But that's my Picasso collection. This is like my Let's Resin collection. These are just pigment dyes, which is, okay, this set here, those are opaque. These are transparent, and these are transparent. I did these, I was fast about putting up the little bubbles. These are some that I just made. I put them in the little bottle. Wait a minute, get my hand on it. This is like a green gold. Hope I'm not shaking you. But yeah, it's, I made it, y'all. So I don't know. I'll use them someday. I don't know when, but I'll use it. Here is paste that I made. I'm just waiting some time to see what happens. I've also made some like in these bottles here. And I realized, I said, oh, okay, I'm not going to be able to stir it. So I got to figure that out. But let's see. Over here is my Arteza collection. Okay. So I do like Arteza, but I don't use them very much. I do not use them very much, but I have them in the case for when I do use them. Okay, so that's the Arteza. This is Teca Roots, which are some very nice pigments. Okay, I don't know how big or small the company is, Teca Roots, but they have some nice micas. That's all of Teca Roots. Above Teca Roots, I have something mixed up. This Teca Roots do not belong there, but okay. This is some soap dye. This row is from soap dye. That's one of the first, I wouldn't say the first, but it was in an order that was like some of my first orders for getting mica powder, because they were cheap. And, you know, I was on a budget, y'all. I'm still on a budget. up here, oh gosh, my arm can't reach. Up here is the first collection, the two-tone collection for May Spring. Okay. Beautiful. I love them. There's more soap dye. Okay. And Teca Roots over here. Some more Teca Roots there. Up there is some glitters that I have. Okay. Oh gosh, my arm is so tired. But there are more glitters. And I'm just gonna bring you all back down. So you see, it goes from, let's see, can I back up a little bit? It goes from there and it goes all the way up to the ceiling almost. Okay, now right here, see, can I get you up here? Right here is just rocks that I've made from, well, gems that I made. Okay, I'm trying to get up closer. I'm so sorry, but they're just gems, and it was from like when I have resin, and I would just pour whatever color that I was using at that time, I just pour it into those that gem mold. Okay, and I showed y'all the alcohol that I made. I showed y'all that last night, but for the ones that didn't see, this one is what, Jewel Scent Aqua Pearl. It's a pretty color. I like it. But it's 15 of those up there. Okay. This one, this set here, These are Baltic Day. All of these are Baltic Day until it gets here. So I don't know if I can get the whole thing. Yeah, that's all Baltic Day. Now here is my Dr. Phil Martin's Bombay ink. That's the collection from, I think that's the first or second collection. It was very expensive. So my daughter bought me those for Christmas. Not last year, year before? I think year before, I'm not sure. But moving down to, like, I buy these, the 4 ounce bottles of my Pinata inks. I buy those because I was making a mess. You see how this black is all messy? I was making a mess. That right there is more the Bombay ink. And this is my Casting Craft. But I made a mess. I have some of the small bottles, but then after I started making so much of a mess, I just put them in alcohol ink bottles. Now here it stops. Nope, here. It stops here. Okay, because these are test runs for the paste that I was making. So, on to the messy desk. The messy desk. So I have extras of stuff. I keep my leveler out. I hadn't put anything up. This is a gift that I have to open up. You know, I gotta have the Mountain Dew right there, y'all. But that's my collaboration project that I'm working on. Normally my computer will sit there and, you know, I'm across from there. So, yeah, that's my, this is my shop. Oh, and I'll show you this too. This is rigged. I have a pole that my husband built, you know, and I wrapped it with the, I wrapped it with the, what do you call that thing? Stuff that you lay down on cabinets and stuff. I had wrapped it up, okay. And I just leave my camera so that it's pointed down so that y'all can see, you know, what I'm doing here, okay. Everything that I do here, I just have my camera pointed in that direction. Another thing that you may want to know is I have my ring light, which I don't use anymore. It goes like way up, y'all, way up. And this is the big light, if I can go back some. Well, I can't go back, but this is the big light that I use. I'm trying to watch my step. That's the big light that I use for when I'm creating. Okay, so eventually I'm gonna move my table and everything. I'll move it to the center of the floor and I will be able, because this thing goes all the way up, all the way up. But that's what it is, y'all. It's my the light, okay? So, and that's where I sit. Now, over there where you see the resin and stuff, it's like just barely anything in those bottles. Today I'll have new resin coming in today. I'll move all of that, clean everything up over there. And you can see a little peek of my, right there. I have my, where's my finger? Right there, you see the cup. I have my, Turner. I have my Turner there. So, that's what it's like in my shop. Now, I do have two tables that are like full of stuff that I just throw over, and I'm not going to show you that because it's a mess, but I am going to see, can I show you, let's see, I'm going to take you up like this first. I do have Oh gosh, I'm not gonna be able to do it. But here, so I keep a lot of my molds in there. Those three drawers are full of molds. And I just keep them there because I have no room. I have no room. But yeah. That's a heater that's got to go in the shop. That right there is my older Cricut machine. And I'm not going to show you anything else because it's a mess. So I don't know how I'm going to get it back turned around so you can't see everything. Now, over there, it's a lot of stuff down there. Like stuff, just stuff that I have to get rid of. Okay. So, and like this stuff down here, it's a mess. You know, it's the three tier, little holder. But like I said, it's a mess. That's my little refrigerator. I do try to keep a stock of my Mountain Dew in there. But that's it, guys. That is it. So I'm glad I got a chance to show you like some of the things that I do have in my shop. But there's things that I really do just need more of. And it's just, you know, I it's stuff that I need. Doing the videos, you know, I love doing videos, but you do tend to run out of things. And I didn't show y'all this stuff right here. I have different little like extra vinyl pieces that I would use doing different things. It's just a lot of stuff. Paper, cardboard paper and stuff like that. Cardstock paper that I bought, you know, while I was using my Cricut. And like this is overfilled, you know, but I try to keep it so that, you know, I made these boxes out from this material. It looks about like the Brahmin bag material. I love Brahmin, y'all. I really do. I have several bags. This stuff here is just random things that I need. Sometimes I don't need it, sometimes I do. Folders. It's just random stuff. It's a lot of stuff that I don't need, but it's a lot of stuff that I tried to have. Oh, I want to do an experiment with y'all, with this, the tissue, the gift tissue paper. I did a nice experiment with that, y'all, one day. I wish I could find the little plate that I did, but I don't know where it is right now. But these are like the books that show you, that has the different type pages and things in there. Okay. That's the biggest part of it. And more stuff. So, this is my shop. And if you feel that you want to donate to my shop, for the videos to, you know, just keep moving, please send in $1, $2, anything helps, y'all. Anything helps. But I do have a fairly decent collection of things, and it's just I do tend to run out. I do tend to run out, like micas and alcohol inks. I have that stuff. And I've recently just got these tints. I want to get some more tints and different type molds, like the really nice molds. I don't know how to explain it, but I want a better quality type molds. So yeah, this is it. This is it, y'all. So I kept you all for 38 minutes. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. I kept y'all for 38 minutes. Y'all see that? I did that. I did that. That was cute. I did two of them. I did two of them. But anyway, I will let y'all go. I love you all. I will see you all tomorrow, which is Wednesday. And y'all have a great day. Bye.